Hello everyone, my name is Konstantinos Sfikas and this is a presentation of a paper that was co-authored by me, Professor Antonios Liapis and Professor Georgios Yannakakis. The title of our work is Monte Carlo Elites, Quality Diversity Selection as a Multi-Armed Bandit Problem. In this paper, we are treating the pattern selection process of the map elites algorithm as a problem of exploitation versus exploration. We address this problem through the UCB formula, a method which is commonly applied to tree search optimization. Effectively, our method manages to increase the algorithm's performance through a better resource allocation. Having said that, let's now move on to a closer look on our methodology. The basic premise of our proposed method is that it replaces the random parent selection of the map elites algorithm. Instead of that, it biases the selection, favoring individuals with a higher rate of offspring survival so as to optimize the algorithm's resource allocation. The curiosity score is a pre-existing method that also biases selection based on offspring survival. However, our method is substantially different from the curiosity score as it treats the bias in a rather different way and explores its relation to important aspects of the algorithm's operation. Apart from using the offspring survival rate as a selection bias, our proposed methodology includes three unique characteristics. First of all, it examines the selection bias from two different perspectives. The offspring survival rate can refer either to the offspring of a specific individual or to the offspring that have been produced from a specific cell of the map elites archive whose contained individuals may change over time. Second, our method emphasizes that parent selection can be perceived as a multi-armed bandit problem, where the exploitation of known good parents must be balanced against the exploration for unknown yet potentially good parents. We are using the UCB formula as a way of addressing this problem, as it is one of the most extensively tested methods of its kind. Finally, we should point out that our method formulates a deterministic prioritization score, which embeds both exploitation and exploration. Consequently, it can be used directly without the need for additional probabilistic methods such as tournament selection or roulette wheel selection. In this slide, we may see how exactly we are using the UCB formula in our method so as to calculate a selection score for each individual or cell of the archive. The left part of the formula expresses the offspring survival rate and promotes the exploitation of good parents. The right part, on the other hand, has nothing to do with the bias and simply promotes the selection of parents that have not been tried out as much. When the number of selections of an individual is zero, we treat its selection score as infinity, effectively giving a top priority to individuals that have never been selected. Since the balance between exploitation and exploration is such an important aspect of our methodology, we are also including the following two variations in the set of examined methods. First, as shown in the bottom left formula, we are testing exploitation on its own, so as to compare it with UCB. And second, as shown in the bottom right formula, we are testing exploration on its own. The exploration formula has been simplified, but is practically equivalent to using the right part of the UCB formula. All three methods are tested in the two available variations, per individual or per cell, resulting to a set of six different approaches. Apart from the variations of our own method, which we just described, we are also testing against three different baselines, so that we can establish a comparative overview. The first one is a greedy selection method, which is based on the parent's fitness. The second one is a default random selection method of the map elites algorithm. And the third one is the curiosity score, which also biases parent selection based on offspring survival, but treats this bias in a rather different way. In order to establish a concrete evaluation of our proposed methodology, we tested it in three different testbeds that exhibit a varying degree of complexity and difficulty. So let's move on to a description of those testbeds and an overview of the results. The first experiment is based on the Rastrigan function, a mathematical formula that exhibits a large number of local optima, which makes it ideal for testing quality diversity algorithms. We use the six-dimensional version of this function, so the genotype is a vector of six real numbers. The behavioral dimensions are simply the two first values of the genotype vector. The displayed figure summarizes the results from the perspective of the QD score, which is a typical performance measure for QD algorithms. The QD score values are measured in the range between 10 to the 3rd and 10 to the 6th evaluations, allowing us to observe the accumulation of quality and diversity in the archive across time. As we may see, there is a clear distinction between the UCB-based methods and the baselines. Although they eventually converge to a maximum, the UCB-based ones are rising faster and retaining this advantage across the whole range of generations. UCB per individual in specific performed the best overall. However, all six variations of our method performed better than the baselines in this experiment. The displayed animation shows the accumulation of fitness in the archive during a single run of the algorithm. On the top row, we can see the behavior of random selection and curiosity score, while on the bottom row, we can observe the behavior of UCB per individual and UCB per cell. It is clear that both variations of the UCB method are managing to cover the entire area of the archive faster and more uniformly than the two showcased baselines. This is especially visible during the initial stages, so let's freeze the animation at 15,000 evaluations to observe it. Furthermore, the UCB per individual method in specific manages to reach its highest fitness across the archive earlier than all other methods. This can be seen if we let the animation progress up to 80,000 evaluations. Once again, despite their different performance, all methods eventually reach a similar state given enough time. The second experiment is based on the so-called ARM repertoire testbed, which is also commonly used for evaluating quality diversity algorithms. The problem represents a simplified simulation of a robotic arm that has an arbitrary number of degrees of freedom. The genotype is a vector of real numbers, in our case 12, that represent the angles between consequent parts of the arm. The objective is to minimize the variance between those angles, and the behavioral dimensions are the resulting coordinates of the endpoint of the arm on the 2D plane. As the results showcase, the UCB-based methods once again offer a significant performance advantage over the baselines. In this example, it is the UCB per cell method that performs best, and not the UCB per individual, as in the previous example. However, similar to the previous problem, all variations of our proposed method are performing better than all the baselines. By observing the accumulation of fitness in the archive during a single run, we can once again see the different behavior of the examined selection methods. In this case, the UCB per cell method manages to establish a good coverage much faster than all other methods, as is clearly seen at 15,000 evaluations. Similar to the previous example, given enough time, all methods converge to a very similar state. Finally, the third experiment is based on a maze generation problem whose purpose is to bring our method in the context of procedural content generation. For this problem, we are using five behavioral characterizations, including various types of symmetry as well as various topological characteristics of the generated mazes. Those five features are tested interchangeably as either behavioral dimensions or the objective, resulting to a set of 30 variations of the same problem. The best performing method in this experiment was UCB per cell, similar to the previous one. Interestingly, however, in this problem the curiosity score performed much better than in the previous ones, managing to surpass the performance of UCB per individual. Finally, both UCB-based methods, as well as the exploration methods, still perform better than the default random parent selection. Although our paper mainly focuses on an algorithmic optimization, we should point out that in the context of procedural content generation, map elites can also be used as a form of expressivity analysis. In this example, we may see the distribution of fitness along the behavioral dimensions of horizontal symmetry and percentage of corners, as well as some indicative examples of mazes generated by the algorithm. As a short summary of the experiment results, we would like to point out three key observations. The first one is that the UCB-based selection methods offer a consistent performance advantage over all baselines and across all testbeds. The second one is that the proper selection between the per-individual and per-cell variations seems to be a problem-specific option. The third one is that the exploration-only variants yield a better coverage but not as good quality as UCB, while the reverse is true for the exploitation-only variants. So, to conclude, let's point out the most important contributions of this paper. First of all, in this paper, we framed parent selection in the context of map elites as a problem of exploitation versus exploration. Furthermore, we proposed that the exploitation component should be based on an indirect property of the individuals, which is the survival rate of their offspring. Finally, we introduced and tested two different ways of measuring offspring survival, per individual or per cell, and found out that the cell-based approaches are more robust and perform better in most cases. Overall, our proposed methodology offers a significant performance advantage over the default map elites algorithm and showcases a new path for the optimization of QDE algorithms in general. Thank you for listening.